Hello again, everyone. Khonius here. Today I thought I would fly around Phoenix, since that's just where I landed on my learning to fly tour, and see what the sights are like. Looks like there might be some really interesting sights. There's a waterway that goes through. So let's go ahead and get started. No autopilot, but we'll go ahead and take off, take the parking brake off. Start heading down the runway. Okay, nice smooth liftoff. Get a little bit of height and then bring the flaps up. Go ahead and retract the landing gear. Bring up the flaps. Alright, we're going a little fast, so let me go outside, and the purpose of this is to actually look around, so let's do that. I've only been to Phoenix a couple of times, didn't really spend much time there, don't really know much about it, except it was hot. See what looks like a freeway down there.
Southwest 133, clear to land runway 26. Call on a generic on final. With 25903.
So this looks like a lot of industrial kind of stuff. I do see a town, downtown skyscraper area towards the right. Ooh, going a little fast. Not sure what that is. It looks like maybe some kind of a technology center or a campus. There goes right there on the left. See a lot of solar panels. Okay. Alright, well maybe I'll follow this particular freeway for a while here. Maybe I'll take this. Continuing to drop the throttle because it seems like we don't need a whole lot of thrust at the moment. And I don't want to keep the needle up there in the yellow zone. Oh, I see an interesting waterway over there to the left, so I'll explore that. The downtown is to our right, so I think I will start getting in that direction. I guess I'm not the only one that gets that annoying. I've heard that on more than one occasion, exit runway when able, and sometimes I'm not able, and then you feel like you're kind of being nailed, but I understand. Alright, it looks like there's a couple of sets of skyscrapers that are interesting. So here's this one. I don't know what any of these buildings are. I'm sure somebody who is familiar with Phoenix would find this very recognizable. I don't think one would normally fly this close to buildings, but we're in a video game, so who cares? Okay, well, obviously Wells Fargo, Western Union. Hyatt, oh, that's a pretty Hyatt. I hope that's a rotating restaurant there, maybe. Sheraton. Okay, maybe some housing or apartment buildings here or something. I love those green roofs down there. Alright, let's see what this is over here. I'm not really familiar with the area. I'm a little afraid to bring up the VFR map. The last time I did that, I got a desktop, so I'm not going to try that. There was a warning about it with the patch 2 instructions. I think, or maybe it was the Japan update, I'm not sure. It said to open the VFR first, don't wait. And just a lot of interesting buildings. I think this must have been a city they spent some time on. It looked like very particular kinds of buildings. I suppose I could turn off the ATC traffic and be quieter, but I feel like it adds to realism.
Icon 855 miles northwest of Sky Harbor 1,600 feet. Request clearance to transition to Bravo airspace.
GH282 Phoenix approach. Spot 4643.
Spot 4643, GH282.
Alright, so we got the co-pilot taking care of all the traffic.
Radar contact 5 miles northwest of Sky Harbor 1,500 feet.
So I guess this is a bunch of residential.
Cleared through the Bravo airspace, KH-282.
Love the red roofs. So my goal is to head back left towards that waterway, then follow it along, looking for sights. A little hard to look down and fly the plane at the same time. Okay, so I think it was in this direction generally. Huge amount of detail. The GPU seems to be keeping up with it. Frame rate seems just fine. Not listening, not seeing stuttering to them, except for me. I think this is a stadium or something like that. Very interesting. I don't think it's enough parking for a stadium, but maybe a convention center or something. I feel like the water might be close to all this vegetation over here, so that's where I'm going to head, hook to the right, and get there and go now. I do see some water off in the distance. This might just be a aquifer here. I so just a lot of residences here. Maybe some schools. This looks like a manufacturing plant here. I'm gonna head towards the visible signs of water. Hangar Haciendas, that sounds fun for some reason. Must be some kind of manufacturing or refining or something. Alright, so I see what looks like a bridge over here. Maybe this is the waterway. It's a little dried up here. If this is it. I looked up Phoenix online and I saw what looked like a lavish, fully stocked river going through with stuff along it. So maybe this isn't the right place, maybe this is something else. Okay, so that's the downtown area we were just visiting before. Still not sure about the waterway. Kind of looks to me like that's actually it, and it's dried up here. This is a seaplane, so I was thinking, well, maybe I can land and float around a little bit. Look at things up close. This looks like a pick your cart yard or something down here. Maybe just a regular junkyard, who knows. And then there's a bunch of buildings over here, like a campus. Maybe it's a car manufacturing plant with all the cars parked or something. I think that sounds like another aircraft, or maybe it's reflections of my engine off the ground. Go inside and listen for a second. Yeah, it sounds fine. This plane has an amazing view from inside. You can actually see something. Alright, so we're adjacent to the airport. Now there's a little bit of stuttering, but you know, it happens sometimes. Usually when it has to download something. A lot of industrial here. What are they making for this? Yeah, I see some water in this direction, so let's head over there. Interesting kind of odd-shaped building here. Is that a waterway directly below? It looks like it's pretty narrow, so... Yeah, it's just like a creek or something. And then we've got the freeway. I'll follow that for a bit. Water. I don't think that's the waterway I'm thinking of. Alright, well we'll head over to Tempe and see what's going on over there. There's some, well, it looks like some water in that book. I think I'm right that their waterway is kind of in a drought, at least according to these satellite photos, the satellite data. Those barriers down there are interesting. Let's see if I can see anything like that. Alright, well we could actually just sit down in the water and float around a little bit. Probably past that next overcross. I don't know if I can get underneath though. And all the pretty stuff's back on this side, I think. Alright, I think I better head back up and around. Thank you. angle of attack meter seems to be upset, but I don't think there's anything down here. This plane can handle a lot of stress. Yeah, it's a little crazy, but I think I can do it. Just quickly drop the flaps, drop the throttle, try to land and not crash into that wall over there. I might have to dive a little bit to burn off some speed, maybe. I don't know if that's going to hurt the plane. I think it'll be fine. Mountain. I can turn in time because I can't really slow down. Alright, well that's kind of a problem. Let's see what we can do about that. Of course the landing gear's not down because I was doing a water landing. To get this thing to turn. And go back into the water. Can't seem to get any kind of forward motion. Maybe if I wiggle it or something. I kind of don't think that's going to work, but you never know. It's spinning around, so I mean, the thing's actually moving. It's just not wanting to go forward at all. Okay, well, I think I'm going to call it at that point. Thank you so much for watching. A little disappointing. But that happens sometimes. Apologize to the plane. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.